Hey everyone, welcome back to Introduction to Bifrost Visual Programming. In the previous tutorial, we scattered points and created instances as a preparation for simulating fog and bonfires. Today we'll take a small break from the landscape because I want to go over the basic setup of a simulation for you to have a good understanding of the system before we apply it to more complex scenes. There are three types of systems that we can simulate in Bifrost. Aero, such as smoke and fire, particles, like dust and fireworks, and MPM, which stands for material point method. Some examples of this system include snow and sand. Whichever system you're simulating, the basic setup is the same. This diagram shows the basic setup for any simulation. We need a simulation engine where all the calculations occur. For it to run, we need to provide it with a source from which the properties or materials are emitted. For example, if we want to simulate smoke, we need to provide air. If we want fire, we also need fuel. In addition to the source, we need to provide the engine with settings of the environment, like the ambient temperature, as well as the simulation accuracy, like the step size. The engine, source, and settings are the only three required components for simulation to run. Optionally, we can add colliders, such as walls and ceilings, to act as barriers, and we can add influences like wind, dissipation, and vorticity to change the properties. Now let's see how to set it up in Bifrost. Here I created a little monster. There's a link in the description for you to download the file if you want to follow along. Say, I want to have smoke coming out of his antennae, like in this picture. To simulate that, let's get a simulate aero node, which is the core solver, or say, the engine for aero and combustion simulations. To provide the source, we use the node source air. It asks for geometry. I've created two ellipses as the emitter geometry. Let's bring them into Bifrost Graph Editor and combine them using Merge Geometry. Here, right-click and select Fan In. This allows the port to receive multiple inputs at the same time. Alternatively, we can drag both geometries into Bifrost as an input by path. Wire the merge geometry into the source air, and now we have our emitter ready. For the simulation engine to function, we also need to provide solver settings. In this case, we use the node aero solver settings. Connect it to the settings here. Connect the aero volume to the output. Play it, and we have our simulation working. To better visualize it, we can assign a material to the smoke. Go to Hypershade under R node, select AI Standard Volume. Click Presets under Default Bifrost Aero. Select Replace. This sets the density channel to be the voxel fog density from our simulation. And we can pick a color. Let's middle drag it into Bifrost. Get an assigned material and connect the material to volume material. At this moment, the resolution is pretty low and the smoke looks too uniform. To modify the properties, first let's go to the Parameter tab of Source Air and take a look at the parameters. The current resolution mode is relative, meaning that the voxel size is proportional to the size of the emitter. This makes the simulation a lot faster for large objects, but at the expense of the resolution. If we switch to absolute mode, then the voxel size is the same as the fluid detail size, which is the size of the smallest detail in the smoke or other property emitted from the source. Run it again, we see a much smaller detail size and a higher resolution. We can also change the fog density, say 20, and it produces a lot more smoke per unit space. And we can give it an initial speed upward so that it travels faster. Now, instead of applying a constant fog density, we can also vary the density to make it more dynamic. The way to do it is to get a vary source property node, place it between the mesh geometry and source air. This node allows us to change a property based on the values we provide. For example, in this case, we want variations in fog density. If we set the min and max to be 5 and 20 with randomized value selected, it will generate a random value between 5 and 20 as the fog density for each voxel of the source. If animated is selected, this randomization will also vary over time. Here's a complete list of properties that can be varied. You can try varying, say, temperature or initial speed to see how it affects the simulation. Right now, the smoke still looks too uniform. To make it appear more natural, there are a few things that we can do. For instance, we can go to the settings and change the style from smooth to fluffy. And we can use vorticity influence to stir up the smoke. Connect this to influences. And we start to see some swirling movement. If it is too much, we can tone it down here. In real world, smokes dissipate. To simulate that, let's add a dissipation influence. And we can adjust the rate here to control how fast it decays. If we play the simulation for a little while, we'll see that the smoke penetrates this structure. If we want this structure to act as a barrier, we can set it as a collider. Connect it to geometry and the output to colliders. This will make the smoke flow around the structure. We can use a smaller detail size to eliminate the gap between the smoke and the barrier surface. Let's also bring the monster into Bifrost and add it to the collider as well. This prevents the smoke from permeating the body of the monster. Here's a rendered animation of this simulation. Another commonly used influence for aerial simulation is wind. We can adjust the speed, direction, and drag to drive the movement of the smoke. That's how we set up a typical aero simulation. We have the simulation engine, source, settings, and optionally, colliders and influences. In the future, to speed up the setup, we can get the node basic aero graph. Explode it and start from there. Basic graphs for other types of simulation are also available. For other types of simulations, the graph follows the same structure. For example, if we want to simulate particles, we use the node Simulate Particles as the engine, and use Source Particles and Particle Solver settings to provide the source and settings. And if you go to Windows, open Bifrost browser, you'll find examples of different kinds of visual effects, and you can import any of these graphs into the Bifrost graph editor. That's all for today. In the next tutorial, we're going to apply what we've learned today to generate fog for our landscape. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.